Hey, how you guys doing? I'm back, Lex. So the M12 artillery, I actually don't have it fully upgraded. I actually just got the motor in this game. Me and Burnout Guy. Burnout Guy has actually had this for a while. He's really good at it. He actually got, I think he got his mastery or ace tinker today in this game, which is really cool. So anyway, if you guys don't know Steve, Steve's the armor man. He's going to show us all the stuff, how big the gun is, how much damage it does, speed, all that stuff. So take it away, Steve.
Alright, I'm Steve and I am the Armor Man. There's not much to look at as far as armor goes. This is pretty much, you wouldn't want to shoot this with like a tier 2 or 3. You do get some, the tracking here, but yeah, high explosives usually you would want to put pretty much anywhere on this tank. The gun is one of those, it gives you a zero rating, or maybe it counts as 50. So you have to be able to have 50 for the pin. So armor's nothing. I mean, it's an artillery. So gun-wise, you actually get two choices even with your stock gun, which is 90 penetration with standard with 1250 damage, or you can get 88 with 1250 with the standard. So that's the standard, and then you have the premium. Now it comes with two guns, which is one, it's the same gun that you actually have on the M44. Well, close to it. It's a very similar gun, but it doesn't do quite as much damage. It does like 850 instead, so just some stuff to keep in mind. So when you do get it does 85 pin, and then it does do 90. So about the same amount of pin, it can do more, slightly more or less damage. I'm very new with artillery, so anyway, to the specifications. As we've seen, let's see, damage with this particular gun would be 950. Let's look at it as though it's fully upgraded, so you guys can see. 1250 is a one shot for a lot of medium tanks. So yeah, damage per minute is 2085, which is pretty good. See here. Reload time is 35 in game. That's with no gun rammer, nothing like that. Now I will mention to you that you cannot use gun rammer with the first upgrade. So, but it is very fast. Well, let me just show you. If you get the 100, you can see that the reload's actually pretty good. Yeah, about 10 seconds less. But with gun rammer and stuff, you can get that down significantly. That's where gun rammer really was meant to be, well, to be used, was on one of these. 10% of 35 gives you in the 20s range, so that's pretty good. So max rate of fire 2.6, actually 1.6 rounds per minute. Yeah, you get 20 shells, so you do want to be very careful. You can see 330. You can transmit though at 782, so your transmission rate is actually better than most tanks I've seen. This is probably the highest I've seen. That's a tier 10 radio. So accuracy is 0.69, which is terrible. This is obviously PC, but it is the same. Aim time is 7.19 seconds. So for artillery, these are things I'm not very good at saying, or showing. It does go, it does get up and go though. It actually will do 38 forward, 10 reverse, which is very slow. 20 or 15 would be much better. That's pretty much that. I mean, armor and stuff. There's really nothing to go over on this tank other than that. So anyway, sending it back over to Ibiko.
Okay, so here we are on Swamp. So it's very rare to see a platoon of artillery. I've seen them before, but I didn't really think they'd be very effective. But it basically gives you the ability to two-shot people, meaning like, track, kill, or kill, track. It doesn't matter either way. You're gonna see me and Burnout Guy using communication. So we're like low tier, low on the here. So there's some tier nines in here. Now Burnout Guy is fully upgraded. I am not. Which is the difference between something like 5 penetration. Now, I was discussing with him that I've seen artillery. This is my first time using this particular artillery on this map. Actually on almost all the maps. This is one of them I have not played, but I have seen artillery sitting here. And one of the good things about this particular spot is, one, you cannot be seen unless they come from the left or right, which means you can get a shotgun ready if needed. And it's kind of funny, when I first looked over there, I was like, oh my god, it's all cloudy. So this is a relatively long game, which I did debate on fast forwarding it, because I'm not actually going to be like the star of this. I do believe that Burned Out Guy is actually, he gets his mastery in this game. So I was talking to him that all these areas that I'm actually looking at, I'm looking for traces of anything moving, but I was trying to tell him that these are places that, are actually, I always seem to see somebody up there. Eventually somebody pops up there, and that in this particular spot, it gives you perfect access to that location where artillery can hit you. And of course, all along this ridge line right here, you can actually land quite far. It kind of tricks you a little bit. Now, it depends on where artillery is. So this is amazing though. If you guys look at this, Tell me this guy does not love this spot. Now, if I was in a Tiger, I've actually gone to this spot before. But I didn't like it because I was kind of trapped. And I kept thinking I was going to get flanked. So the whole time I was sitting over here, I was sweating. So I'm just sitting there thinking, you know, he's going to pop out any second. I'm going to kill him. He's not really aware. But I'm sure he probably is aware. So, yeah, I had some crazy games with us today. We probably played like, I don't know, like 5 or 6 games in a row with this. Relatively fast games and winning games at that. I will say that artillery can break a game. Seriously, make or break it. So, me looking at this guy and then seeing maybe if I can get some possible splash damage. Now I see this T-29. I actually call it out to a burned out guy and I'm like, yeah, I'm going to take the shot on him. And I get a really good first shot. So 322 is pretty good for this non-upgraded gun. I am experimenting with the, I just loaded 5 more of the premium shells, to increase the amount of damage, but I really haven't seen, to be honest, and of course, total miss, I really haven't seen a huge, difference, in that, using premium high explosives and not. The premium high explosives obviously pin a little bit more. But they do cost 5,200, which is a little out of my, willing to spend range. But I do try them out here and there to see if I can get, like, max damage. For instance, there are certain vehicles, like, for instance, medium tanks, that if you were to use that particular type of round, you will do lots of damage. Now, I could try and track him or even try and, hit him from a distance, but I just go. It's much easier to go for slower targets. Mediums are just too quick. It is possible to hit mediums, but these guys over here are probably the most threatening to us. The other guys would need to cross a river and go directly through the middle of the swamp. So for me, this is probably, priority. And I could see this guy marking and saying he's having a problem with this guy. So I'm aiming directly for the, 30mm plate that is on the IS-3. Which is on the turret. There's actually 2 places, but as you can see, I missed. So if you watch the action, you're just going to see burned out guy just start burning these guys out. So I'm going to go ahead and just pop off some rounds. And I don't know who shot that guy, but it's a good shot. Here's a motherland. A KV-4. The KV-4 is probably the most detrimental to the team. He also is the easiest to hit. He's really tall. I noticed that just because of the sheer size of it, it's very hard to miss it. Motherland got toasted. And let's go ahead and see here. So the idea here is to hit this guy while moving. You see, he goes to the left. I end up hitting the motherland. I actually said that. I said, look at the motherland still doing its job over there. So here's a T-43, which could be another threat technically. He could be a threat. One, he could spot us. So I decide I'm going to go ahead and pop a shot off and maybe get him out of there and just falls short. Just boom, falls short. But burned out guy actually caught him on fire. He actually caught 2 tanks on fire in this game, which is going to give him, super amounts of damage. So I'm trying to guess where this guy is going to be. I decide to not fire for him and I decide to go for the biggest threat, which is the tier 9s. I also see that there's some guys fighting over here to the right, and so burned out guy actually caught him on fire too, and you can see there, boom, burned out guy and CT. Now I do believe there's a couple shots here where it's like I just get these random shots, I just like guess, and I just just let it fly, like that one, and nothing, right? So I'm at 3 penetrations, 3 critical hits, 3 shot spotted, which is different, but they do count. So let's see here. Yeah, long game. It's like I said, if you guys want to see a really good game, a burned out guy doing getting an ace tanker with a M12. Now I can just speculate on the fact that once I get the fully upgraded gun, it's a little bit more accurate, does have a little bit longer reload time, which means I do have to be more careful. But I will get gun armor. So the aimer for me has always been very effective. So here's a T-71, which is kind of like a nightmare. And I'm finding that this area right here is kind of a trick, which explains why I've always been safe over here when I play, TDs or something. It's a tricky area. So all of a sudden, artillery just decides to jump out. And so I'm going to pop off a shell, and I fire, and I'm like, oh, man, he moved. And then he backed up right into it. I end up getting a critical. So burned out guy, he's like, all right, I'm going to try and take a shot. And I was like, yeah, he's just to the right of that hole I put there. And so he fires, and burned out guy overshoots. And he was like, I must have actually fired over the top of him. And I'm like, I'm going to go ahead and just try one more in that spot. And I hit him. I actually hit him. He's still there. And boom, I got my first kill, which was crazy, considering that I had to guess that he was there. I'm really surprised he didn't move. If it was me, I would have moved out of there, you know. But here we go. Borsig, there's my second kill. I've been kind of capped out with this tank so far at 2 kills. Not to ruin it for you, but if you guys watch, you'll see Burned Out Guy, you know, he's actually been getting a lot of kills, actually. I believe he's on going to get 2 more, or he's already got them, one of the two. Now, I check here and I go, wow, man, if I get 1 more kill, we'll have Brothers in Arms. And he's like, okay, well, let's try and 1-2 these guys. And I'm like, oh, here's an artillery. I said, I got to let my reticle shrink a little bit. Got to let it shrink. And, oh, somebody hits him. I'm like, oh, shit. That would have been perfect right there. Could have gotten the Brothers in Arms. Would have made it even better game. So I'm kind of like, you know, saying, hey, they're probably in the spawn. So here we go, Yag Tiger. It's kind of a tough tank. The upper part on it's like 40 millimeters, which means I'm not going to be doing like crazy amounts of damage. So I'm assuming he's still there, but I don't want to just pop one off. I kind of want to wait till he's detected. And as you can see, he did move back, so I'm going to go ahead and fire one. And you can see that he moves right when I fire. So much for that. So I got, you know, 9, 8, 7, 6 more seconds. And he's just down to a little bit. I'm just hoping I can fire off that shot and it gets killed. So that's that. So I want to save the round for whoever gets next. I'm pretty sure the last guys are over here, you know. That's where they usually are. There's also a little cubby hole to the right where they could be. Which, you know. So I'm just letting my reticle shrink as much as possible so I can, you know, get it in there. And so I'm basically telling Burnout Guy, I'm like, you know, dude, just take the shots, man. If you need to just take the shots, don't wait. And so I'm like, my reticle is really big. I gotta wait for it. So I'm waiting. And I'm like, if you hit him, I should be able to pop him. And I'm like, all right, I'm ready. And I think he says he's still reloading. So I fire early and I do hit him and I do 336, but basically I left them with 46 health, which that sucks. I did switch to the, premium high explosives for that. And I knew right there that the chances of me getting this, you know, was going to be very slim. But me and Burnout both knew that the Tiger was here. And it's you know, that was pretty much a wrap. But overall, I thought it was a really good game considering we were platoon. We were the last people alive taking out all those guys. 3-2, that's 5 altogether. Which is really good, and you can see here I did 1500, got 1700 XP on a non-double, and that's pretty good. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this. Comment, like, and subscribe, and have a good one. Later.